Hello children, welcome for today's biology class. So today we are going to continue the chapter photosynthesis in higher plants. So the topic going to be covered are that is C4 pathway, that can be known as Hatch-Lack pathway also, and the differences between C3 and C4 cycle. So previous class we studied regarding C3 cycle. So today we are going to cover C4 cycle also. Along with that we will see the differences. So, in the case of C, I already told you the plants know they do photorespiration. So, when there is excess oxygen in the atmosphere, and apart from that, so when there is high temperature also, the ribulose biphosphate enzyme, so it does the oxygenase function. So, here what to avoid that photorespiration, some plants know they show some adaptations. So, here the primary primary carbon dioxide acceptor, that is no phosphoenol pyruvate in this, and the enzyme, the new enzyme, so here involved is PEP carboxylase. Okay, here the mesophyll cells, they lack Rubisco enzyme, and here one C4 acid, that is oxaloacetic acid, is formed in mesophyll cells, and later the C4 acid and later converted into malic acid and aspartic acid. So here these plants, they show the special anatomy called Kranz anatomy. These are some special features. Okay children, the primary acceptor is PEP, that is phosphoenol pyruvate, and the enzyme involved is PEP carboxylase. Okay, and here the first, that is C4 acid, okay, the formed is oxaloacetic acid, and later converted into malic acid and aspartic acid. The special anatomy is shown here, you call that as Kranz anatomy. Okay, so here I told you the C4 acids, so what formed and in the bundle sheath cells, it breaks to release carbon dioxide and 3 carbon molecule, and later, and that 3 carbon molecule, it can enter inside Kelvin pathway. Okay, so here now let us see the cycle, then you will understand. This atmospheric carbon dioxide, okay, it is getting fixed up in the form of phosphoenol pyruvate, and that carbon dioxide, it is 3 carbon compound, it is 1 carbon. So 3 plus 1, 4 carbon compound, C4 acid, that is oxaloacetic acid, is formed. And later it is transported inside from mesophyll cells, it is transported inside bundle sheath cells. Okay, and the C4 acid, after reaching here, decarboxylation occurs. So when the decarboxylation occurs, so it breaks and releases one C3 acid, and along with that carbon dioxide also released, and the carbon dioxide it enters inside the Kelvin cycle, and the C3 acid, once again it is transported, okay, and it helps in the regeneration of phosphoenol pyruvate, and once again it picks up 3 plus 1 4 C4 acid, comes here and releases carbon dioxide, and the C3 acid once again come here and picks up, like that the cycle it is going on repeated. Okay, so here this type of pathway you call that a C4 pathway. That's the thing told here children, the steps, the primary acceptor, carbon dioxide acceptor is phosphoenol pyruvate, and the enzyme involved is PEP carboxylase and OAA, and regarding malic acid and aspartic acid. Okay, and here after that the regeneration, once again it is being transported, C4 acid comes in and breaks to release carbon dioxide, and once again it is being transported to mesophyll cells to form PEP again. Okay, this pathway you call that as Kelvin pathway also. So now let us see regarding C3 and C4 cycle. Okay, so in the case of Kelvin cycle, the plants following C3 plants, and the plants those who are following C4 pathway call that as C4 plants. So here the primary carbon dioxide acceptor, so here ribulose bisphosphate, so here that is phosphoenol pyruvic acid. So the first stable carbon compound formed is PGA, that is phosphoglyceric acid. Here formed is OAA, that is oxaloacetic acid. Then the chloroplast is monomorphic. So they have only one type. And here the chloroplasts, they are of dimorphic. So the mesophyll chloroplasts, they perform C4 cycle, and the bundle sheath chloroplasts, they perform C3 pathway. So here the mesophyll cells C4 cycle, and the bundle sheath cells they do C3 cycle. And the leaves, no, they do not exhibit Kranz anatomy in Kelvin cycle. So here in Herzlag pathway, they show the special anatomy called Kranz anatomy. So here the photorespiration occurs in C3 plant. Here the photorespiration very rarely occurs. And the C3 cycle, it is less efficient, okay, in utilizing atmospheric carbon dioxide. Here it is no more efficient because it can fix atmospheric carbon dioxide, no? That's why it is more efficient. And the plants are adapted to all climate conditions except saline conditions. So here the plants are adapted to climate, and they can all climatic conditions, and apart from that, so they can tolerate, no, the saline conditions also. So that plants, you call that as halophytic plants. They can live in saline conditions. Okay, children. So then later, that C3 cycle, it is no less energy expensive. It requires only 18 ATP for synthesis of one molecule of glucose. But the C4 pathway, it is no more energy expensive, and it needs no 30 molecules of ATP for the synthesis of one molecule of glucose. Okay, so here these are the different differences we studied. And now let us see some C3 plants. C3 plants, for example, soybean, wheat, rice, and all, no, spinach, tobacco, all coming into this category. And C4 plants, this corn, okay, and sugar cane, and millet, and all, no, coming into this category. Okay, children, sometimes examples also being asked in exam, and the diagram, the C4 pathway can be asked separately, and the differences also can be asked. So different methods, the in exam, no, the questions are being asked. So study thoroughly. Okay, children, we will meet in the next class. Thank you.